Let's dig deeper into troubled adoptions. Before the break, Gary Tuchman took us to a ranch in Montana that tries to help adopted kids who are too troubled, too dangerous to raise. It's a risk families take whenever they adopt, of course, but it's a risk that Dr. Jane Aronson is well aware of. She's a pediatrician and CEO and founder of Worldwide Orphans Foundation. I just want to be clear, this is pretty rare. I mean, I don't want to dissuade somebody from an international adoption. It's pretty rare this kind of thing happening, right?
Absolutely. Reactive attachment disorder is exceedingly rare, although attachment disorder, different kinds of attachment issues for children who've been adopted from abroad are pretty common.
What is reactive attachment disorder?
Reactive attachment disorder is a rare and very serious disorder of a proportion, you know, I can say, is an intense disorientation to intimacy. So the child cannot bond or connect to anyone and often becomes incredibly violent and can threaten the lives of animals in the home or people in the home.
And is that generally in kids who have spent more time in an institution?
The hypothesis is that the longer a child spends in an institution, the more risk there is for them to have reactive attachment disorder. But I want to also educate the public about the fact that there are many children who don't spend an inordinate amount of time in institutions who end up with attachment disorder, particularly RAD, likely because they have early damage to their brain during infancy due to exposure to alcohol, malnourishment, smoking, drugs, environmental toxins, and infections. So it's important.
So there's an actual physical damage?
There's actual organic and physical damage that now has been studied by neuroscientists who really have analyzed and looked at the brain using CAT scans, MRIs, PET scans, etc., and have shown that children can have damage to their brain early on and not have sustained long periods of institutionalization.
So what can a parent do? I mean, in a case like this, the ranch that Gary talked about costs like $3,500 a month, obviously a lot of money for a lot of folks.
Well, I don't think that most kids with reactive attachment disorder end up in Range for Kids, by the way. I think lots of kids undergo an array of treatments. There are many therapeutic modalities that can be used for kids with attachment disorder. There are family therapy situations. There's individual therapy, play therapy. There are medications, behavioral management, therapeutic environments in schools, group work, sports, music, arts. There's a lot of different approaches to reactive attachment disorder, and it isn't necessarily necessary for children to go to a ranch for kids, although it is a great option if it's something that families can afford to do.
Is it common that somebody who's gone through the process of adopting decides to then give back the child?
The concept you're talking about is disruption or disillusionment, and the range of statistics on this are very, very wide. I mean, you know, if you look at Barth and Berry's data, you'll see that maybe about 10% of adoptions will end up with disruption or disillusionment. And I think that it's really important for everyone to understand that it's rare for disruption to occur for adopted children, both domestically and internationally, by the way. We have to also bring in that people do disrupt adoptions domestically. But it is last ditch. I mean, it's really at the end when people have tried many different things to try to help themselves and their families and their children that they end up disrupting. One more point I want to bring up, though, is that often it's not discussed from the beginning. And it's really important that families understand that that's not something we want to happen, but it's important if families are thinking about ending the adoption or not finalizing their adoption, they need to be able to have an open channel to talk with social workers and psychologists about their feelings, because that's when the danger occurs. And that danger is post-adoption depression and post-adoption actual attachment disorder for the parent. Many parents actually have attachment disorder themselves because they don't willingly accept the child's problems when they're first adopted. And then they become depressed and they actually aid and abet attachment issues for the child.
Wow. It's got to be devastating for everybody involved to dissolve an adoption after it's gone through the process.